that what they believe in is true. And so it's very difficult to come before these people and say what you believe is wrong, even though you present biblical reasons that what they believe is not biblically based. They say, well, not everything that God does is in the Bible. You can't put God in a box. One man said that if everything that happened on the day of Pentecost was written in the book of Acts, you would need a wheelbarrow to carry the book of Acts around. But that's building a theology based on what the Bible does not say. We are to build our theology, our doctrine, on what the Bible does say. And that's why people get off into these deceptions, is because they base their theology on experiences, but not on the Word of God.
I think the crucial issue is, what is the nature of our mandate? Is our mandate to preach the gospel or to preach and to heal? If our mandate from the Gospels is to preach the gospel, and we then add something onto that, whether it is church attendance, the sacraments, any ritual of any sort, or healing, then we are clearly adding to the gospel that we were given, and therefore it is another gospel. And whereas the Reformation had to wrestle with works being added on, and whether you're saved just by faith and trusting in Christ, so today it's faith plus healing.
The consequence of going into an altered state of consciousness and having suggestions made to you and you becoming hypnotized is that you do have a mind-changing experience. The common word for this is a paradigm shift. Go to the drug culture of the 60s and you will find that's exactly what they were talking about, mind-bending drugs. Now, some of them discovered that you can have mind-bending experiences under meditation, TM, all these kinds of things, bent people's minds permanently in some instances. And that's what we're seeing happening. People's minds are being bent by the effect of their experience. So the experience rules, the suggestions made while they were under that experience are the rules that guide them. Scripture is now simply a lip service statement. Oh yes, well, we can find a verse about it somewhere, usually totally out of context. That's what's happening to people. That is why, unless they repent of the experience, they are not going to be able to hear the Word of God. And there is the catch-22 for so many. They cling to the experience as proof to them that God has his favor on them, instead of clinging to Scripture, where we have the eternal promises of God, which cannot be changed.
If I had one thing to say to the charismatic world, and I had the opportunity to say it, I think it would be to say, focus on Jesus, not manifestations of the Spirit. Focus on Jesus Christ and salvation through him. And read your Bibles and use your brains and question everything else.
Perhaps the only solution to the apostasy, if that's what it is, the gullibility certainly of so many Christians today, is that those who stand apart from so much that is represented by modern charismata, and there are good Pentecostal people who would stand apart from a lot of the peripheral things today, the only solution is first for Christians to be living such quality lives that the attractiveness of their lives will make people realize there's something better than the hype I've been led to believe is all important. And the second thing is that those in positions of teaching and preaching must maintain a clear biblical standard, testing everything by Scripture, but with a life and a vitality that is in itself attractive. The church in the 60s betrayed itself by allowing hordes of people to go into the charismatic movement because, frankly, they themselves were so dull and boring. And we have to show that there is a better alternative, because there is a better alternative to hype and pretend.
Our desire in making this video is to reach the many sincere people who are being lied to and deceived by the kind of ministries we have highlighted in this program. Jesus said there will be many people who will cry, Lord, Lord, on the day of judgment, and that these will be people who genuinely believe that they were saved. We do not want anybody watching this program to be one of those. Many people who were formerly charismatics later discovered that they were not born again, after examining their teachings and experiences by the Word of God. We are exhorted in Scripture to see whether we really are in the faith. To have this assurance, we must have come to Christ by the biblical route of repentance and faith, which can only come by the preaching and teaching of His Word, correctly interpreted and faithfully taught. Out of the many people who will see this video, there will be some who will begin to walk with God in a new way. Not by sight, looking for signs and experiences, but by faith in the Word of God that is sure. The first thing you must now do is get away from anything to do with these deceptions and study the Word of God for yourself. Then pray and ask God in His time to put you in contact with sound Christian friends, where you can truly grow into the image of Christ and experience genuine Christian fellowship. If you have any concerns, please feel free to contact one of the speakers in this program, who will be more than happy to help you find the right road. And once again, thank you for watching.